Let's go. We see the hype outside, right from the house. Took it straight from outside, straight to the couch. We put the mic outside, edit shit out. What's up, guys? It is TGX Viper here. Today we'll be introducing you the most overpowered weapon loadout you can have in Modern Warfare in the current update. This thing has actually, like, stayed in the game for God knows how long, and it's still overpowered. So I want to quickly share it with you guys. This is the MP7 build with the riot shield and all the perks and lethals and stuff. So first of all, you want the overkill perk. I've seen many people do this before. They put the riot shield in the first slot. When you spawn into the game, whatever you have, the weapon that you have in the first slot is the one you spawn with. So if you have the MP7, you're going to spawn with the MP7. If you have the riot shield, you're going to spawn with the riot shield in your hand. So I would equip the riot shield on the secondary slot, so you spawn in with the MP7, which is really good for maps, for example, shipment. So getting onto that, you got the right shield to cover your ass. The MP7 build. So on this, you want the recon barrel. This thing is absolute nuts. It's got damage range, bullet velocity, and recoil control. This thing shoots like a psychopath. Anyway, it only sacrifices a little bit of aim down, sight speed, and movement speed, but you can hardly tell, so who cares. Some people, if you want it, you can have it. The 5MW laser, this thing is really good. I use it as well, but I've been trying out this other little build to include the Merc foregrip. I just had pretty much, I swapped it out for the grip tape because that makes me aim quicker and I wanted that. So the laser, we got the sprint to fire speed and hip fire accuracy, which is really good with the Merc foregrip. So you guys can choose if you want that. It is really overpowered, and I would suggest this attachment if you want to trade out any of these other ones. For the optic, you don't need an optic. Iron sights on this weapon is already deadly enough. For the stock, we want the close quarter stock. This ain't like the aim down sight speed. It says the pros as aim down sight speed, but little did you know that it actually gives you a little bit of a mobility boost as well. It is a bit of a constant back and forth between which is better, the no stock or the close quarter stock. I personally think the close quarter stock, because no stock you literally like gain so much recoil, like this thing goes all over the place when you have no stock. So if you can control recoil and you know how to, then it's good. Like I personally can, but I just like to have it cleaner with the stock, and I would suggest this if you are kind of new and you are new to like controlling recoil. So I would suggest the close quarter stock. This thing has improved aim down sight speed, and it only sacrifices a little bit of aiming stability, which you can't tell. Moving on, we have the grip tape, which is the rear grip, and this thing is aim down sight speed mostly. It is for sprinting and also normal walking aim down sight speed. Once again, it sacrifices a little bit of aiming stability, but we literally cannot tell. With this grip, it's actually a lightweight grip, so you gain a little bit more mobility as well with that. Ammunition. With this gun, you will find out that you can just munch through kids with this gun, so you want as much rounds as you have, like you can. So if you're high enough level, you can actually get the 60 round mag, and you just pepper kids with it. So I suggest the 60 round mag. For the Merc foregrip, that the laser sight and this foregrip is literally like husband and wife. They're just meant to be. The recoil control, it's nuts. Like you get like practically no recoil at all. Like with all the attachments and this as well, you get like no recoil, and hip fire accuracy, it like works like a dream. Aim walking, movement speed, like who really cares about that? Before you even bloody walk, you're gonna kill the person, so who cares? It like sacrifices a tad aim down sight speed, but we've already got pretty much four attachments that boost it, so it doesn't really make a difference. So we got some really good recoil control and some improved hip fire accuracy. So there you have it. That is the MP7 build. This thing is insane, and hopefully you guys can comment and tell me what you think of this and what new builds that you guys have actually found out that will, like, we can
try out ourselves and hopefully share with other people. And we'll feel free to give you a shout out if you share us a weapon build that you guys think is quite overpowered. Anyway, so we're gonna get on to perks. So with the 60 round mag, you're gonna pepper through your ammo like no tomorrow. So you want the scavenger perk. If you want to just keep like banging kids with this weapon, you want the scavenger perk. But if you're more about like score streaks and stuff, I would suggest kill chain or like probably double time if you're like even more aggressive and you want that double, that like that tactical sprint which makes you go faster. So it's either double time, scavenger, kill chain, or quick fix, because quick fix, once you kill someone, your health regains really quickly, so that's also really good for this class. But I would suggest scavenger, because you're going to go through your like your ammunition really quickly. Obviously overkill for the riot shield. You can pick pretty much whatever you want for the third perk. I would suggest tracker, shrapnel, or amped. Amped, you get a so it's either shrapnel, tracker, or if you really want, you can get tuned up for them like really fast like tactical sprint, or the sneaky sprint, whatever it is, the ability that you can use, that's really good with this class as well. So I would suggest using that. So tuned up, tracker, or shrapnel. You can pick pretty much whatever lethal that you like. I like putting down a proximity mine and just going on a rampage, and then somewhere in that rampage I just get a proxy mine kill. So C4 is also really good with this class. Stun grenades, that is like stun grenades are as powerful as they are. So you can use whatever tactical you want, but I suggest a stun grenade because they're really good. That's the weapon loadout for today. Hopefully you guys like and subscribe. We're going to be doing a lot more of these, and we've got a Red Dead Online 2 money glitch coming out very, very soon. So hopefully you guys can subscribe and turn on notifications, and hopefully you'll get notified when we post that, which will be very soon. And to end this clip, we're going to show you a little bit of gameplay on Rust with this weapon build. I got like 71 kills or something. It was pretty nuts. So hopefully you guys like, and we'll see you in the next video. Peace. She filled my mind up with ideas. I'm the highest in the room. Hope I make it out of here. She saw my eyes, she know I'm gone. I see some things that you might fear. I'm doing a show, I'll be back soon. That ain't what she wanna hear. Now I got it in my room. Legs wrapped around my beard. Got the fastest car at Zoom. Hope we make it out of here. When I'm with you, I feel alive. You say you love me, don't you lie. Don't cry my heart, don't wanna die. Keep the pistol on my side. Cases fumes. She fill my mind up with ideas. I'm the highest in the room. Hope I make it out of here. We ain't stressing about the loot. My block made a case for real. This not the molly, this the boot. Ain't no coming back from here. Live the life a lot familiar. It's so much gain that I can't see her. Turn it up till they can't hear. Running, running around for the thrill. Yeah, dog, dog, run my reel. Raw, raw, I've been pouring to the real. Nah, they not back of the veal. Gorgeous, baby, keep me hard and still. It's my life, I did not choose. Been on this since we was kids. Fill my mind up with ideas. Cases fumes. She fill my mind up with ideas. I'm the highest in the room. Hope I make it out of here.